I awoke to the sounds of Lily's gentle snores as they drifted across the bedroom loft. She was still fast asleep, and I needed to keep it that way, or suffer the consequences. Creaky floorboards meant that the simple act of getting dressed will require a little ingenuity. Morning, Dougal. Yoink. Lily made a fish and marmalade sandwich for me the day before. I didn't have the heart to refuse, but I wasn't about to eat it.
Oh, that stinks.
I freed my sweater from Lily's clutches, but I was still out of reach. Should be able to get the trajectory right. Boots, check. That was my cue to sneak out of there. I decided I'd cycle to the nearby town. Maybe I'd find someone willing to hire me. Maybe I'd find someone who knew where my dad had gone. But first, I had a few things to take care of. The jug. I'd need water to make Lily's breakfast.
Strange light?
Ah, it's a package from my father.
Arthur, this is the last of the small crystals. I hope this was worth giving up your job for. I'm still finding the whole notion difficult to believe. I'm tempted to make a trip to your home to see it with my own eyes. But the fact that you keep the generator in your bedroom is quite unsettling, to say the least. If what you say about the lesser crystals is true, then I fear what may happen when this company begins experimenting on the large one. It's still safe for now, but I don't think it'll be possible to smuggle it out of here without anyone noticing. Given the apparent results of your own experiments, it's possible they'll listen to your warning. However, it's more likely they'll see nothing other than the potential for profit. For now, I'll do my best to impede their research. Stay safe, my friend. Nina.
The strange crystal was obviously important to my father. I couldn't help but wonder if it had anything to do with him going missing. I decided to do a little snooping around. pump handle had snapped, leaving only a small section of it protruding from the pump. It was going to take something heavy to force it down. Looked like the pitchfork had fallen from its resting place. Yet another impressive feat of engineering. Dad, where are you? Didn't really stop to think where my dad got the mask or why he wanted it. I was pretty sure I could put it to good use, though. Dad made his own generator to power his workshop. As with his other inventions, he just refused to explain how it worked. It looked like there was something missing, but I hadn't figured out what. There, that should keep it cool. Let's see. It fits. Huh? It's glowing. The whole wall was covered in writing. Whatever I did, it caused the machine in the back garden to power up. All this power from a crystal. Cooking utensils hung from the wall by the fire, for now at least. I'd recently made Lily a small wooden sword so she'd have something else to swing around. Dad's compactable footstool seemed like a great idea. I wasn't sure why it hadn't taken off.
Sure enough, the lights and whatever other equipment Dad constructed were receiving power. I wasn't sure if I was getting any closer to figuring out what happened to him, but it was the best lead I had. Itself. There was a 50-50 chance that it was intended to respond to vibration, or that it was simply as reliable as the stepladder. It was one of the puzzle boxes my father often made for Lily. I wasn't sure why he hadn't given her this one, but I knew she'd be happy to have it. I wanted to give Lily the puzzle box I found, but she was still asleep. Lily, does, when in doubt, dance it out mean anything to you? Right. How did that dance go again? The secret dance routine turned out to be the solution for the combination lock. Inside the box there is a small key where the tasty treat should have been.
About the right side.
Hey!
So hungry. Need breakfast.
Look, Dougal, everything's laid out already. I should just make it myself. It's porridge. What could go wrong? Big old bag of oats. Prepare to be eaten. Hey, wait a minute. It's empty! Okay, I can fix this. All I need is a fresh bag of oats, a new bowl, and then to place a pot over the fire. Thank you. This is easy peasy. What was Dad worried about? Dougal, attack that string. Someone's at the door, boy. Silly doggy. Hey, Dougal, I think someone's at the door, boy. Silly doggy. I've never adventured on an empty stomach. Hey, Dougal, I think someone's at the door, boy. Silly doggy. That breakfast wasn't going to prepare itself. Why didn't Granddad invent something like that? Hey, Dougal, I think someone's at the door, boy. Silly doggy. Hey, Dougal, I think someone's at the door, boy.
Wait till Dad hears I did this all by myself.
Hang on. Where is Dad?
For a moment, I wondered where I was. Then I noticed everything was different. I was different. But it was when I thought of Lily that it no longer mattered why. I couldn't let her think that she had lost someone else. Somebody had left their belongings on the floor of the strange room. After glancing over the items, I realized some of them belonged to my dad. So this is where you went. It was unusual to see Dad without his hat, and vice versa. But then again, it was noticeably warmer than home. I decided to take it with me. A glass jar had been left next to the other belongings, emitting a faint white light. Assuming unusual objects to be important seemed like a good rule of thumb, so I picked it up.
A
Okay, let's figure this out. Whatever the rightmost socket was supposed to do, it didn't seem to be able to do it while the lab was unpowered. Placing the jar into the left socket had restored basic power to the lab. Whatever the rightmost socket was supposed to do, it didn't seem to be able to do it while the lab was unpowered. Placing the jar into the left socket had restored basic power to the lab. Just enough power to distribute to the door release. It took a large amount of power to get me here. Logic dictated that it would take something similar to get me home. I was gonna have to venture outside to find it. And in the back of my mind, I hoped that I might find my father along the way.
To town without telling us. Oh well, time to go to work. The stretchy rope from the tractor. Every adventurer needs rope. Right where I left it. Proud of my giant slingshot. Huh? I wasn't strong enough to pull myself back. Customers. Dad says we're running out of money. He's doing his best to find a job. He's probably gone to town for that exact reason. So until then, we've got to do our best to help out. Hey, Breeze! You didn't pay for that! Good thing wings can't ride bikes. Wait, if Dad's bike is still here, where's he been all morning? I had a bad feeling, and I was pretty sure it had nothing to do with the porridge. Hee-yah! With Gnome out of the way, I was free to start looking for Dad.
Felt like a dream. I was being led down a path, and, short of curling up into a ball, I was helpless to do anything about it. I considered going back inside and just waiting for someone to find me, but I knew that if I wanted to get back to Lily soon,
I'd have to find the source of power for the machine that brought me here. And I wasn't coming back until I found it. Like the blue lamp also acted as a door release.
Speed, Sir Fuzzlepuff. He's gone. Of all the souls I have encountered in my travels, his was the most fuzzy. Dougal, this must be where everyone went. What if something happened? I need to go after them.
As I wandered deeper into the swamp, I began to feel uneasy. From the gnarled and twisted branches of bizarre trees, to the clamor of unrecognizable creatures filling the air, it was clear I was a long way from home. Thank you.
incredible! I couldn't wait to see what Dad looked like.
See many like you.
Who are you?
Mare? No, just Mare.
I'm not sure where I am. Can you help me get home?
Maybe help each other? Come, sit. My people lived here once long ago. They had machines, kept us warm, safe. Now I am alone, and the machines not work.
Well, I'll take a look, but if I do, will you help me get home?
By fixing machine, you return home.
So it's the same generator that powers the lab. Okay, show me.
Follow.
Next to Mare's toolbox was a single peculiar glove. What is this?
Whoa!
Careful!
Sorry.
Careful!
The crystal hidden behind the wall looks similar to the one I had seen earlier that day.
Something happened!
I picked up a screwdriver from the overturned toolbox. There was a large bulbous plant blocking a pipe at the top of the stairs. It felt like it was full of water. In one corner of the room were several flowers laid out in a grid pattern. There was something familiar about it.
Hey, I think that worked. Hey, what are you doing? Get out of here! No, no, no!
Can I help you?
My name is Nina. I'm a friend of your father's. I've been out here for a while thinking about how to say this in a way that you'd believe me, But then, about a minute ago, I heard that sound. You've been there, haven't you? To Clonfira.
Yes, and I need to get back there.
You mustn't go back there! It's dangerous! Your father, he was killed! I'm so sorry!
He... what? Lily! Lily's there! In Clonfira!
You have to help me bring her home, please!
Oh my god! Come with me! We need to get to my lab, hurry!
But then he spat me out. He's probably not used to his food poking him with a sword. And then I saw you! Although, you already knew that bit. You're a good listener, like Dougal. Hey, what's your name, by the way? Well, you're like a big bug, so I'm gonna call you Bugsy, okay? So, will you help me find my family? Okay, first, let's get out of here. I might be able to climb this. Oof! Or not. Hey, Bugsy! Give me a boost! Doggy door this whole time? Come on, then. Hey! Ooh. Oh, look at that thing! It's like a into one of these flowers. Evidence. Smell this. Wait here. I'll be right back. Okay, I don't have any more crystals of the type Arthur used, but I have this.
Wait, why can't we just use that on my father's machine?
Because we don't want to blow up the whole countryside. I'll explain when we get to my lab. I'm hoping that I'll be able to send you to Clemfira from here, but they're not going to just let me bring someone into the building. You should be able to sneak in through the side entrance. Just make sure no one sees you. I'll go on ahead and get started. See you soon.
Hang on, Lily. I'm on the way. Somebody had hidden the key underneath the flower pot.
I'm usually a stickler for avoiding fire hazards, but this was for the greater good. My new psychic had left me with a way in. I'd made it into the canteen. The worker was still there, facing towards the lift. I'd be standing on a narrow ledge above a hydroelectric dam, I wouldn't have gone out of bed that morning.
Ah! Whoa!
It wasn't gonna help me fly, but I figured I could use it for something.
There you are. What took you so long?
What?
Never mind. I need your help with something. I'm almost ready to go here, but I need something else for this to work. A cavity magnetron should do the trick. The easiest one to get is probably from the microwave oven upstairs. I'll finish up here. Let me know when you've got it.
Hey, Jerry!
The microwave oven was in use, but I didn't have time to wait.
At least there's no sign of the bird this time.
Thank you.
Great, thank you. This'll just take a moment. Alright, I followed your father's design as closely as I could. Put this on. Now, this crystal is different from the others, much more powerful. With the lesser crystals, you need to find a place where the fabric of our reality is already weakened. But with this, we should be able to tear open a new gateway right here.
Thanks.
Aim that way. Aiden, be careful.
Give me that. Oh, where am I? Granddad. No.
Lily? Lily! Wait! There you are! What are you doing here? Come on, we have to get... Lily?
I thought I lost you too. Maybe it's not too late to save my dad. Dad! Granddad! You're okay! What? Mommy? What? No! Why did you make me say that? Hang on, Dad, I'm not leaving you! Dad! Keep him busy for a sec!
Hey, you! Big ugly monster! Over here! Look at me!
Okay, I'm gonna jump down now!
What are you doing here? Are you okay? I'm so worried.
I was looking for you and Grandad.
Lily, Grandad...
I know. Can we go home now?
Wait. Mer, he stole the glove. We needed to get home. Come on, quick. We can't get stuck in this place.
Mer, wait!
No more waiting. This time, I go!
I bet Grandad would have loved this thing. I bet Grandad would have loved this thing. I recognize Grandad's old radio sitting on the floor. I wonder how that got there. I bet Grandad would have loved this. I bet Grandad would have loved. Nope. Grandad's hat was on the edge of the pool. He must... To do something! Hey! This must be Grandad's glove!
Who is this?
Huh? I'm Lily. Who are you? Over.
Lily, this is Nina. I'm a friend. Where are you? Your father's been looking for you. He's really...
Oh, don't worry. He found me. Well, I found him. But then the bad guy with purple hair tried to trap us here. So Dad went to stop him, and now I can see them fighting in the back garden through this magic mirror thing. I'm not making this up.
No, I believe you. Look, when the portal closes, the radio will stop working. If that happens, I promise I'll come back to get you somehow. Just stay safe.
Why is he doing this?
Our world sustains his kind better than his own ever could. It's complicated. They left him behind long ago. I suppose he just wants to see them again, even at the cost of hurting other people.
He wants to see them again? Maybe I could give him what he wants.
Lily, don't do anything. Just stay put.
Okay, you big monster. You owe me.
Be alone anymore.